So, for those of you who don't know, there was once a driver named Nyck de Vries in F2. Nyck was a rising star, winning the F2 championship after a dominant year in 2019. But due to the rise of next-gen drivers in George Russell, Alex Albon, and Lando Norris, arguably Alex Albon, but still, there were no seats available for Nyck, leaving him to squander in the shadows of Formula E, the World Endurance Championship, and being a reserve driver to the Mercedes F1. Nyck is a prime example of a driver that has all the hallmarks of becoming a great driver, especially after having won the 2021 Formula E World Championship, but due to financial restraints and poor timing, he never had the chance to shine on the big stage of F1. The same can be said about Alpine junior driver Christian Lundgaard, someone who from the start has always been hailed as one of the best rising talents, but has unfortunately never had the opportunity to show this, and with a recent switch to IndyCar, his dreams of F1 may be crushed. Christian Lundgaard started karting professionally at age 11, and within 3 years, he was able to win 3 major titles. Starting in 2012, Christian won Kart Cup South, the South Garda Winter Cup in 2015, and the CIK FIA European KF Junior Championship as well. After having won the European Junior Championship, Christian made the step up to SMP F4, Spanish F4, and Danish F4 in 2017, all with the MP Motorsport team. Christian won both the SMB and Spanish Championship and finished a respectable 11th in the Danish version. Overall, Lundgaard took 17 wins and 32 podiums over all 3 championships, a very solid first year in Formula Racing. Heading into 2018 off the back of a strong debut in Formula Racing, Lundgaard made the step up into Formula E Renault Euro Cup, again with MP Motorsport. Lundgaard took 2nd place only to Max Bouchel, along with 4 wins and 10 podiums that season. Beyond the Euro Cup, Lundgaard went into the NEC division of Formula Renault, where Lundgaard took 2 wins and 2 podiums in only 8 races, a very high finishing rate for such a short stint. Speaking of short stints, Lundgaard also took a venture into GP3 with MP Motorsports yet again, finishing near the bottom in the 2 races he competed in, but made the opportunity for him to race in GP3 the following year. 2019 saw many a change for Lundgaard as once again he switched racing categories as well as teams this time, going into Formula 3, the Macau Grand Prix, F2, and even the F3 Asia Winter Series, all in 2019. Lundgaard's season in F3 was highlighted by the dominance of Robert Schwartzman, yet Lundgaard took a win at Hungary and 2nd place in his debut race for a full-time drive. Add to this that Lundgaard changed teams from MP to ART, and one can see why Lundgaard was such a star in the making. Macau was also a strong showing for Lundgaard as he took 4th overall in the race and qualifying over 4th overall, finishing 3rd in the qualifying race and then losing 3rd to Logan Sargeant in the main race, a strong showing from the pair overall. F2 was a surprise for Lundgaard as he was called up to the season finale with Trident, finishing 14th and 12th in the 2 races, showing off his promise in F2 and in a horrendous car that year. 2020 came and once again, Lundgaard made the step up, going from F3 to F2 this time, sticking with ART in the process, giving him time to grow as a driver. Lundgaard did surprisingly well in the uber competitive season that 2020 was, with him taking a win at the Red Bull Ring, another at Mugello, another 4 podiums, and gave Lundgaard a 7th place finish, only 2.5 points off of fellow Alpine Academy driver Bun Yu Cho, a much more seasoned veteran and now rising F1 driver. 2021 was a season that many were hoping where Lundgaard would break out and show his true talent and pace. But instead of moving forward from 7th place in 2020, Lundgaard's fallen to a current 11th place, with him only taking 3 podiums so far, and with only 1 race left, no wins to his name. And after yet another season of Alpine deciding not to promote their junior drivers, Lundgaard decided to sign with Royal Leatherman Larrigan Racing for a multi-year contract in IndyCar, yet another driver going off to the States to try and make their path instead of going to F1 due to the financial restrictions and the cutthroat world that F2 and F1 academies are. All in all, is Lundgaard another Nyck de Vries, a driver who will never get their chance to make it to F1? Well, I contend that Lundgaard is like de Vries in the sense that he isn't in the right place at the right time, but his results also don't help him that much as his last championship win was over 4 years ago, not the best of promotion for F1 teams looking to sign young drivers. But hey, that's just my opinion. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week. Peace.